Gwenda입니다.
Hello everyone, it's Gwenda here. Nice to meet you. To give a brief introduction about myself, I'm currently 20 years old and I'm from Singapore. I've been training with Chaco Entertainment since November 2023 and I'm currently back in Singapore to do my visa. I have a bit more time here in Singapore, so I wanted to make a few videos about my journey to share with everyone who has the same dream as me. Since young, it's always been my dream to become an idol and to make content like this, so I'm really excited and I plan to chat with you guys more often, so I hope you're just as excited as I am. So let's talk about how I became a K-pop trainee. Just like everyone who's watching this video, I really love K-pop, and I was introduced to K-pop from a very, very young age. So in primary school, I would always watch the television, and idols would be singing and dancing in those flashy fits, and they would do really cool variety shows, and I would just always look at them and go, whoa, that's so cool. So I guess I just really wanted to be like them. So when I was a kid, I had a lot of spare time. So what I would do is turn on my computer, it was a desktop at the time, and switch on photo booth, and I would just sing and dance to my computer as if I was in a music video. Sing and I would dance, not knowing the dance, not knowing the lyrics. But I just felt like I was an idol, and that made me really, really happy. And I think my dream of becoming an idol just came naturally from there. So all I could do was really just prepare myself for when the time was right. So I picked up Korean by myself. I remember teaching my friends Korean in primary school, and I would just take part in a lot of dance clubs. So I was in Chinese dance, international dance, street dance, you know, just learn different kinds of dances. I just spent my teenage years just dancing and learning Korean and just preparing myself to become an idol someday. However, once I reached junior college, this dream kind of waned because for practical reasons, I was about to go into university and it was time to really mark out my journey. So I just thought that, you know, this dream of becoming a K-pop idol would just be a dream. So I was just working really hard on my university applications and studying hard for my A-levels. But I found that whenever I felt stressed, I would always, you know, fall back to K-pop, and I was like, you know, I just wanna sing. I would be happier dancing for like 10 hours instead of studying for 10 hours. And so I just always had that dream deep down inside my heart. So after A-levels, before you enter university, there's about 8 months of like free time where you get to, you know, do anything. So a lot of people my age would just work part-time or just kind of dabble in a hobby or something that you're really interested in. So it was during these 8 months where, you know, I proposed to my parents, hey, I just want to go to Korea and like study the language, try to live a bit more independently, and secretly audition. And they were like, okay. So there I went to Korea, and I was just studying the Korean language, and I just took a lot of dance classes and audition classes just to really, you know, upgrade myself. And also part of my decision in wanting to go to Korea was also that I wanted to prove to myself that it wasn't me who sucked, it was just the circumstances weren't it, or I just didn't have the right opportunities. So I wanted to prove to myself that, you know, I was good enough. So it was that time when I was in Korea when I got my university acceptance letter, and I was under a lot of pressure from my parents to just, you know, go back to Singapore and just start my university life. And that's what I did. So that's why I went back to Singapore, taking part in a lot of university camp, and I was kind of really just in the community already. But I think as I was going about my day-to-day life, I just couldn't really shake this feeling of wanting to go to Korea and to achieve what could have been. And so I have this habit of like watching my old videos. So I was just watching my old videos one day, just watching them dancing and stuff, when I chanced upon this video that I took when I was in primary school. And I kind of, in that video, I was just singing and dancing to my heart's content. not even with the right lyrics, not even with the right dance, just singing. And my mom was telling me, like, go to problemsounds.com, like, start studying. And I was like, whatever, I'm just gonna woo! And I think that scene just really touched my heart, because I was just watching and I was like, I can feel this little 8-year-old's passion for singing and dancing, and it would be such a waste if she didn't pursue her passion. So with that in mind, I kind of set out to persuade my parents once again. So I was like, you know, like, please, would you just let me out? So I like make presentation slides, and I just really tried really hard to persuade them. And that was also a time where I started communicating a lot more with my parents. We were able to communicate with each other better. So I think my parents also kind of felt that I was ready and I was a bit more mature to, you know, go to a different country and live there by myself. So they were like, so I went back to Korea. So once I was back in Korea, I actually just put myself through a lot of auditions. I think I took like more than 100 auditions. And this is how auditions would go. So you like prepare beforehand, like what you want to sing, what you want to dance. And so before the audition starts, you're just waiting in a room, and then they'll call you in one by one. And so you'd be like, hi, I'm Brenda. This is my height, this is my weight, this is my special talent, and I'm gonna sing, blah, 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 and I'll sing, and I'll dance, I'm gonna dance. And then if they're interested in you, they like ask a few questions, take a few photos, and that would be it. So that was what I did for like many, many months. And sometimes there would be good days, sometimes there would be bad days. And I think it was just really taxing, because obviously I'm going into an audition with like high hopes. I'm like, okay, I prepare well, I'm gonna like show you who I am, and I'm gonna slay, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that, and I'm just really good, like, please pick me. But then I would always get feedback that about stuff that wasn't really in my control. They'd be like, you're a little short, you're a little old, they don't really fit our image, yada yada. So that was kind of hard for me to accept, because, you know, however passionate, however hard I worked, there were always like limitations to my hard work. I was just not really happy with that. And I didn't know that I was burnt out until it was this audition, and I prepared like a really vocally challenging song. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna smash it. I'm gonna show them how good I am singing. And so I introduced myself as per usual, but when it came to my song, I blanked out. So I was just like, I'm sorry. After the audition, I obviously cried in my way home, and I was like, ah! But I guess that was the moment when I realized, like, yo, I'm so burnt out, like, I need a break. And, you know, taking a break isn't really, it's good for you in a sense where you get to recharge, but it's also bad because you miss out on opportunities. And to me, every audition meant a lot, because every audition is a chance for me to show myself. So not being able to take part in an audition was just, oh no. And so I tried my best to go for every audition. But ever since that little flop that I had, I was like, okay, I need a break. So it was during my break that actually Chaco had an audition. And during my time at the audition academy, I actually had taken Chaco's auditions a few times, and they never picked me. And I was like, maybe they just don't really like me. So I was like, yeah, it's okay. But so my teacher was like, you know, maybe you should give it a try, because, you know, you never know what's gonna happen. But I was just like, didn't pick me, what would be the difference? But after thinking about it, I was just kind of lonely, and I wanted to hang with like my friends at the academy. So I was like, okay, I'll just go for an audition, you know, have fun. And that was the time where I was preparing for a lot of other stuff. So I had like my introductions really well presented. I had like, so my special talent is that I can speak like 4 languages. So I would just like prepare like Korean, English, Mandarin, Japanese, just shoop, and I would just blurt it all out. And I guess it was kind of cool because at that time, the staff was like, okay, can you show us your introduction in four languages? And I was like, ooh, and she's like, so I guess I kind of impressed them with my language skills. Yes, so I passed the first audition. And after the first audition, I actually got a call and they were like, yo, they wanna see you again. And I was like, okay, sure. But usually, like, I've had a lot of instances where, like, they pass me for the first round and then they don't really accept me for the second round. So I wasn't really like, oh my god, like, they're gonna accept me. More like, okay, let's just see how this goes. Let's just not put too much expectations on this. So I was like, okay, chill. I'll take a chill. So for the audition, the second audition, I prepared two songs and two dances as per their request. So the songs that I did were G-IDLE's Dumby Dumby and Nayeon's Love Countdown. And for the dance, I performed Nmix's Love Me Like This and Run For Roses. So I prepared really hard for the audition and I did my thing and they were like, do you have anything else to show us? And I was like, I did everything that I care. And they were like, just anything. And I was like, I mean, I have a lot of things in my repertoire, so if you could let me know, like, you want a song, you want to dance, and I'll be like, okay, I can show you. They were like, just anything, please. And I was like, what to do? So I eventually showed them my choreography, the choreography that I made to Le Sserafim's Eve Sight and the Blue Beard's Wife. And they were like, okay. And then we proceeded to have like a really long Q&A. So my audition kind of lasted like about an hour in total, just cause we were just having so much fun talking. And actually, to be honest, because of how burnt out I was and how, like, you know, I've like taken their audition so many times and things didn't work out, I wasn't like super sure if Chaka were to accept me, like, would I go? Because I just wanted to find a company that really fit me and that we could, you know, grow together. So I wasn't really sure if I was going to join Chaco, but then during the audition, they were like, how likely are you to join Chaco? And I was like, this is a really hard question to answer. It's like, girl, like, what? But then after that, like, as we were talking, they were like, do you have any questions for us? And I was like, so you guys have Chaco in Hollywood. If I were to join Chaco, like, will I be able to be part of that? And they were like, yes, of course. And so I was like, oh, okay. And they were like, who do you like? And I was like, I like Doja Cat. And they were like, yeah, we were thinking of having her. And it's like, oh. More than that, I just felt like after the whole audition process, after looking at the training center, after, you know, chatting with them, I could really feel their genuinity for me. And I was like, if I were to join Chaco, I'd be able to grow a lot with them. So, like, songwriting, producing, singing, dancing, whatever that it is that I was interested in, they were interested in, you know, making sure that I could grow to my fullest potential. And not only that, I think our work ethic was kind of like similar, because I'm a work hard, play hard girl. And when I was just looking at them like working, they were like, but then when we were chatting, we were like, ah. So I figured that, you know, we were kind of similar in terms of this aspect, so we would probably get along really well. So this was a period of time when, like I said, I was very like burnt out and I had really low self-confidence. So I was like, let me ask something that will boost my confidence. So I was like, why did you pick me? And they were like, first and foremost, we really like your bright energy. And you also said that you could speak four languages. And not only that, you were pretty good at Korean. And we just wanted like global talent to join Chaco. So we were like, hey, please join us. Yeah, so that was how things went. And that was how I came to join Chaco. Woohoo! So that has been all on my journey as to how I became a K-pop trainee. Next episode, I'm going to be chatting with you guys on how my training life has been, and I'm going to spill some interesting details about what the training does. So, if you guys are curious about anything regarding what I've said or anything you guys want me to talk about, please drop a comment down below and I'll try my best to respond to everyone as much as possible. I hope today's video has been useful to you, and thank you so much for staying with me. Until next time, bye!